numbers that's marked on them is the lumber that's to be sawed. And you can see that the 3 foot and 4 foot wood is for lobster trap material. And the log, the initials on the logs are the person it belongs to, and if they have a special piece of lumber they need, they'll mark on the end of it, so I'm illustrated to what I have to saw. And I put on a skidway. My skidway was a short because I had two large truckloads of logs brought in. And I've sawn out of 2 days now. And this should be the last day to finish sawing. For small lead, the lobster traps with, because of the very few knots on the butt end of the log. And a log such as this is cut 14 feet long, and it's marked 2x5 for roof rafters. And one like this here is a special one, marked 5x8, 16 feet for a trimmer, like for a cathedral ceiling, a special beam. And as we go, we'll go into the mill. This track in front of the brow here to pick up the logs to be sawed. With a bit and a shank that holds the tooth in. And if you hit stones or nails or something in the log, you can take one tooth out and replace it. And this type of saw is tapered. It's thicker down towards the arbor than what it is here at the log side. And the width of the tooth gives you your saw cut and allows the saw to run freely into the wood. And it's powered by a six-cylinder Chevy engine and run direct in low gear. And the engine has a governor on it to keep the speed of the saw up so it doesn't wander and wobble on us. It's a special chain with great big links that the sawdust doesn't catch into it. Hooked up to a reduction gear, a 40-to-1 reduction gear. And the arbor feeds it off a V-belt. So it doesn't take any power from the saw itself. See the V-belt here on the shaft, how it turns? And this here is my friction gear that runs the carriage back and forth to saw my logs. And that travels from the friction gear down through to a rear axle here, a rear end with an axle onto it, with my cable on a drum that hauls the carriage back and forth.
Yeah, we're taking a quick look into the sawmill area. You can see this machine right in front of us is to cut up saw laths.